This is working. Hi. Hi, Instagram. Hi, Facebook. I'm currently trying to... Okay, here we are. We're live on Facebook. We're live on Instagram. Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining. I'm going to wait a quick second before we start. I've got, like, two different setups here. You guys are on Instagram. You guys are on Facebook. And also watching me without a filter, which is... That's that. But... Happy Friday. How is everyone? I don't know, because we're fully in, like, two different, like, situation setups. So we're gonna just try to make this work. I also don't know if I can see comments on the Facebook thing. I've never gone live on Facebook before, so this is all new for me. Hi, Brooklyn. Hi, Brandon, or John, or whoever's in there. So today, I'm doing a little live for you, because it's Friday night. We have nowhere to be. There's no place else to be but in your stupid house. We're gonna watch. Is someone calling me? Oh my god. Wait 5 seconds, y'all. Hello, I'm going live. Live for this, for your stupid little work the world thing, huh? Kidding. This is my manager. Brandon, I have to let you go. I'm live on Facebook and Instagram. Say hi to 1.6 million people. Well, they're not all watching, but... All right, I'll talk to you later. Bye. The disrespect. All right, well, hi. I take phone calls just like you. We're, like, very similar. I'm living. So yesterday I saw that Gigi Good was also doing one of these live situations. And she cooked up something crazy. She made a very, very, very complicated... quarantine cocktail situation, and as you all know, I am not a drinker, and I'm a liar, but we're not going to make a cocktail today, but I am going to make dinner because I am hungry, so that's what's happening, and we are going to make something that is fun and easy and low budget, low stress, low maintenance and preparation. I usually do a little more complicated version of this in the regular world, but the world's not regular. So I've made like a simplified dumbed down version. It is going to be a fabulous salad, but it's delicious and it hits all of the right spots. So that is my favorite thing. It's kind of taco-y, it's kind of, I don't know, it's like tons of my favorite foods all in a bowl. So like, where can we go wrong? Starting this off, I'm gonna be using some baby arugula. I'll also be trying to like look at the comments, take some questions, but I don't know how this is gonna go. Actually, you know what, before we even start all that, this salad involves corn. So I use just whatever frozen something that I have in my freezer. Also, a lot of these items can be like rearranged into different dishes, so that's why I love it too. But this one's simple and easy. So we're gonna throw, down the sink. We're gonna just like put that much, you can't see this on Facebook, but just imagine there's like corn in the bowl. So we're gonna put all of this corn, not too much, in the microwave. Bam, hit that for 30 seconds. Easy peasy. Now, while that's going, you're gonna wanna get yourself a pan. This one I cooked breakfast in, but that's no big deal. Because why not? So what we're gonna be doing is cooking Beyond Beef crumbles. Usually I get the Fiesta version, which is very Olay, but, see, we're already done with the corn. Gorgeous. But they didn't have it at the store whenever I last went. So we're just using this. I like the vegan beef because I'm not really into, I'm trying to minimize the animal product and all of that nonsense. And this is like, especially when it's like the Beyond products, absolutely love those. Can't get enough of them. So I've got the pan on like, I don't know, a medium heat. And basically what we're gonna do is throw a little avocado oil into the pan. Heat these little ladies up for about, I don't know, like 4 minutes it says, I think. 3 minutes, stirring occasionally. Now, of course, y'all can't see that, but I'm gonna turn Facebook a little this way. Let's move you this way. Ooh, not my whole house. Ugh. Oh, maybe this is a little better for you guys. Ew, how do I get out of that thing? Okay, there we go. Stop texting me. I'm busy. It's literally like they don't realize that I'm doing the thing that they told me to do. Not they told me to do, but that I'm doing. This is hot. We're gonna throw a little avocado oil in it. Boop, 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 boop. Not too much. You don't need a lot, because you're not using a lot of these little girls either. So we're gonna throw, I don't know, maybe... Shut the fuck up. About this much in the pan, and just shimmy that all around. And then you can turn the heat down to low, whatever suits your, floats your boat, whatever. While you're at it, you can toss your frozen foods back in the freezer. All right, glamorous, gorgeous, fabulous. Hi, everyone. Thank you all so much for joining my beautiful cooking show. You freaks keep asking for all this nonsense, so I figured I'd give it to you. Now, while these are cooking, you do wanna, shake it around every once in a while. And because I don't have the Fiesta version, I'm going in with some taco seasoning. Honestly, the one in the little that comes like this is totally fine for making your vegan beef crumbles a little more of a party. En español, a fiesta. So we're just gonna shush a little bit of that on there. Gorgeous. Make sure you shake that around because for some reason, like the... Ooh, the beef goes like wild when you put the seasoning in. So boop and boop, clean off your floor because you don't want any unwanted friends coming over. So we're just gonna, actually I probably shouldn't be using a fork because I'm doing this on a video. I might as well just like use proper utensils and stuff. Use the spatula and just kind of like scrape the bottom of the pan because it do get a little, oh my gosh, the little crusty, crunchy, tasty bits. I'll get up in there and make sure those stay on the meat and not on the pan because then you're gonna lose the flavor. So we're just gonna, those are pretty much like done cooking. We're just gonna let those sit. This corn is not super warm and cooked, but it's better when it's colder. So it's like, you know, salad vibes. Exactly. So, taco seasoning can go away. I love cleaning as I go, so I'm gonna pretend like I'm doing that. Let's see, this is better for you guys. Now, I just leave this in the bowl and I just make everything in the same bowl because who cares? I probably could have cooked the beef before getting on live, but I feel like this is part of the experience for you to see me managing not only preparing this meal, but also preparing to potentially start a fire in my apartment. So, I love arugula, and what I like even more than arugula is youthful arugula, so I chose baby arugula, all right? So we are just going to, this is rinsed 3 times, I think, washed 3 times, so I know that I should not be getting any pesticides or whatever. Is this organic? It's organic too. And it's a woman. Organic girl. Everyone is driving insane today, by the way. I don't know if everyone is just like wilding out for whatever reason, but they are like, everyone is screeching and scratching and stuff. Outside is sounding insane. So this is all mostly cooked. I'm gonna throw this in the bowl with the corn, but kind of set it to the side. Oops, again, what a fucking mess. So that it doesn't, what are we doing? So that it doesn't get like the cold vegetables too warm. This will all cool down fairly quickly as well. Delicious. All right. Oh God, what a fucking mess. Actually, just kidding. I over-exaggerated. There was
not much of a mess.
You want me, I want you, baby.
I'm a potato. Kidding, those are not the lyrics.
So we've thrown a little arugula in here. I'm honestly throw a little bit more because we love our greens. I also don't know how healthy, how vegan. I know this is like not entirely vegan. I don't know the health of it all. I don't know if I'm eating way too much. I don't know if I'm eating not enough. But I'm cooking, so it doesn't matter. So normally I would put this away, but I'm not gonna waste your time any more than right now. So also, I like having a diversity of textures. So we have the regular corn, plain Jane. I'm also gonna go in with a little canned whole baby corn because baby corn is fantastic. I don't know if, is baby corn even related to regular corn? Should I be embarrassing myself by asking that question? I feel like they're definitely two different corns. So basically what I do, I'll just grab two of these little girls, shake off the juices, toss this back in the fridge to use in another dish. I love cooking with baby corn because it just is such a nice flavor, gives a nice crunch. And I'm just gonna chop this into really small bite-sized pieces so that we have a fresh little chomp in our salad. Salad bowl. I know you can't see, but wait, can you see if I do that? Nope. Well, imagine I'm putting the corn in the bowl, okay? You can't see shit either. Sorry. Hi, Facebook. I look so much more pleasant on Instagram than Facebook, though. So, to the 63 of you that are in the Facebook, the 752 of you on Instagram are definitely getting the fantasy. All right. This is so easy to make regularly. I'm tucking my shirt in, not feeling my insides. This is usually so much easier to make, but I guess on a video, it's posing a lot of trouble. But that's okay, because you're going with the flow. Ow. All right, so we've done lettuce. Oh, this is a fun part. We get to use an avocado. I love throwing the avocado into this because it is, y'all know, it's delicious. It gives it a nice creamy texture. I don't like to put too much dressery on the salad, so this kind of convinces my brain that there is some creamiosity in there and it's healthy. So we're gonna have the avocado. We're only gonna use one half. We're gonna throw a little lemon juice on this, wrap it up in like cling wrap and throw this back in the refrigerator to be used maybe tomorrow. That would be a good time to use it because the avocados can usually last that long. So basically I'm just going to go in and very carefully as to not cut through the skin. That part's extremely important. We're just going to do like a crisscross cut on this very carefully, because you don't want this completely mashed up, but I don't like this in big chunks either, because if I'm getting a massive avocado chunk, that means that the next bite probably won't have a massive avocado chunk. And we're just going to plop. Can you see this? There you go. You just plop it right into the salad. Oh my God. Now I hope this was not the side with the little nub on it. I like to even like grind that shit out because and you're gonna try to not get any of the green goop on your hands, but toss the peel, the packaging. Grab a paper towel because it'll be the quickest thing for it now, and wipe that green goop off your hands. I should keep talking just in case this music gets flag for whatever reason. And now, what are we gonna do? We're almost done the vegetable part of everything, which is a pain in the butt. So let's swing. We said if you swing this way, can you see this? No. And I'm not moving you lower because you're at the bottom of the cabinet already, so. Oh, maybe you guys can get into the, all right, Facebook. I see you, now you're getting the cooking fantasy. Fabulous. So this is what, oh, see, I thought Facebook was gonna be a terrible time, but now I'm figuring out how to make it work. Let's bring Instagram back. I don't know. Either or, thank y'all for joining. Is everyone excited for Drag Race tonight? I don't know. I am, although I hate the makeover episode. Ugh, so boring in my mind. But, that has nothing to do with anything. Just not my favorite. We are going to add some tomatoes. Because if you want a taco moment, tomatoes are essential, especially if you're giving, like, salad shows as well. So, these are ginormous little sweet grape tomatoes. That is pretty freaking big. So we're gonna just have these. I'll probably use a handful, because I do like maybe like one tomato every other bite. So we're just gonna have these into little halvies. Drop that into the salad. We got one, we got two. Let's answer a question or something. I don't know how to make people send me questions, but, oh, by the way, guys, if you guys are doing anything tomorrow night, this would be the perfect time for me to plug this. We are going to be on the Work the World streaming situation. Obviously, I've been sharing all of the posts for that on my story and on my main Instagram page, but I'm very excited. We're doing like a battle royale style, and for those of you who do not listen to my bullshit or hear me out all the time, I'll restate kind of what's all going on. Let's get you more on me while I'm talking. I swear to God, also balancing the Instagram and the Facebook is so much more difficult than you'd even think. So basically, there's... Stop texting me! You are so annoying. It's Cameron Michaels. What were we saying? Battle Royale. There's 10 of us. It's me, Cameron Michaels, Evie Adley, Vanessa, Asia, Brooklyn Heights, Alyssa Edwards, Plastique Tierra, Violet Chachki, and Gigi Good. Oh my God, I almost said Gigi Gorgeous. That would have been very incorrect. We're battling the Royale, so we're all paired up there. We're all like performing upon the topic of what do you miss from the outside world. And me and Cameron are both focusing on like human interactions and touch and the feel, the fabric of our lives, essentially. So I'm very excited to debut that little performance. It's very, I wouldn't say it's very different for me, but it's probably very different from what y'all are used to from me. So hopefully you enjoy it. It's one of my favorite songs ever. From one of my favorite duos ever. So check that out. You can find out the information on like worktheworld.com or valsevents.com. Or swipe up in my story. Check it out, it'll be really fun. There's also gonna be a runway segment. There's some extra special other guest performers. Lady Bunny and Bianca are going to be rambling through some stupid jokes. So if you like any of that, you're a freak, but come watch our live stream because all of the tips, the competition part of it. You basically will be choosing which of the girls you like want to win and you tip them, but like no one's winning and no one's losing in theory, because all those tips go to local queens and entertainers who have been affected by it and not having a job today, tomorrow, or the next day. And we've been able to disperse the funds to, I believe, over 60 local entertainers, which is extremely important. So please join. All right, back to cooking. Now, I know everyone is very, this is a very polarizing plant. It is cilantro. It has been washed. And a lot of people don't like cilantro. And I get that, but I do. And it gives me a fabulous, fiesta vibes. So instead of making a salad dressing with this, I would normally like blend this up with like some crema and some oil and what else? Some lime and jalapeno and make like a dressing. You don't have to do all that. Just toss this shit in, like crumble it up and toss this shit into the bowl just as you would the rest of the lettuce.
it all blends in. You get the taste, you get the flavor. You don't have to, you know, get out the blender and make a mess. So I really appreciate that. If you guys don't like cilantro, another good alternative would be to use ground cumin. And I know it's pronounced cumin. But this gives very strong cilantro vibes as well, while not being cilantro. So, I'm also going to be using this later on. Now, I know what you're thinking. This salad is taking freaking forever. And it is. It is. Because that's because I'm trying to entertain you. And we're doing it all on the spot. I was going to pre-prepare everything, but I thought that it would be more fun to see me doing everything on the fly. So, this is what the salad bowl be looking like right now. Gorgeous, colorful, certainly nutritious. Like, it's nutritious, it does all the good tasting things. I don't know where anyone would not enjoy this. So, what else do we want? Cool, now that we have most of everything in there, yeah, I'm like, I don't wanna like miss a step. What I'm gonna do is run to the refrigerator, and we are going to grab, this is the only part of this, I believe, that is not vegan-ish. I'm gonna grab some sour cream, because I don't have anything else. So we're making this make do. We're just gonna go in there with a little forky-dork, and just take, like, honestly, like a spoonful, but of a fork, so like a forkful. We're gonna plop, actually, that was, we're at the bottom, so it's not quite the spoonful that I wanted. And this will give, like, a nice creamy, soury, sour cream flavor to the salad, which is great because it kind of like, I don't know, I like the taste, it's delicious. And what we're gonna do is, I've already halved a lime yesterday, but we're going to squeeze this upon the salad. Actually, why is this so, let me actually cut this in half as well. Because for some reason, the one side was so juicy yesterday, and when I used this last evening, this was not very juicy, so. I'm gonna try to squeeze some juice out of here. I know you can't see any of this, but who cares? I'm the money maker, not the salad. All right, and I like a lot of lime. Honestly, maybe we can show you on Facebook. Ooh, fun, squeeze the lime. Just pretend like I did it. Alrighty. And I'm also planning on eating this, so I'm trying to make sure it's like delicious and not just, you know, me making a shit mess on Instagram and Facebook. Look at how cute this towel is that I got at the Pokemon Center in Tokyo. Sleepy Pikachu. Sleepachu. Okay, so now all of the food things are in here. Now to add the not food things. So as I said before, we're gonna put the cumin in the mix. I like putting it on the sour cream for some reason. I don't know, because it like sticks to that and then the sour cream gets everywhere. It's fabulous. And I honestly don't dress it beyond just the sour cream and like the avocado. I don't know if that's like a weird thing or a good thing, but who are you to judge? Exactly, there we go. Now to finish this off, this salt doesn't like put out a lot, so don't think I'm like going crazy on this, but we're gonna throw some salt on that mixture. We're gonna throw some black pepper that is more finely grinded. I don't know. Let's see this. There you go. Ow, ow. Crack that pepper. I used to not like the concept of salt and pepper on a salad because I thought it was unnecessary, but then I put it on and then it was fabulous and necessary. Now, cilantro, lime, sour cream. I don't have jalapeno on me, but I would probably throw that in here too. Those all go together really well with honey. So I'm just going to throw like a little squirtle of honey in this. I would put this in like the am I being a freak for putting this in? Is this what I want to be doing?
Yeah, we're gonna do like a teeny squirt of this in here too. Because, like, a very teeny squirt. Just to give it like one extra little, you know, little pizzazz. Mix it up. Okay, so now we have this heavy, giant ass salad, and it's gonna be so, so good. We're gonna mix this, mess around, mainly to make sure that like the sour cream and like the honey don't just like be their own clumps. And now that the vegan beef and the corn are all cooled down as well, you just incorporate. And I don't wanna do it, I'm gonna press down my face. I got the feeling tonight. You're just gonna mix this around, and oh my god. Ladies and gentlemen, that took 25 minutes as a performance, but that was so simple. This is so easy, and I probably should not have dressed this, because now I'm realizing that I will have to eat this sooner than later so that it doesn't taste like crap. Okay, let's do a couple questions. Do you guys have any, what's the tea? Like, are you guys talking or are you guys just sitting? Either or is fine. Lots of comments, not a lot of questions. Oh my god. Of course, I'm like all stupid and snotty right now. I've had the windows open all day because it was like dreary this morning, but then it got sunnier, which has been nice, but now I'm all like headachey allergies, but that's fine. Do I miss Westchester? No. I really don't care too much about that. Not in a bad way, but it's just like, you know, NYC or whatever, I don't know. Westchester wasn't meant for me, like, it works fabulous for plenty of people, but it's not my teas. You know what I mean? Plant-based, yeah, it's like a Beyond beef. Oh, and aren't you supposed to eat this when you're done? That's what they always do on the TV shows. So, honestly, I'll probably slice up a couple more tomatoes because this just looks so good. We're gonna get like a delicious bite too. Stab a tomato, grab some lettuce, definitely get some avocado. Anything I'm missing? Some like beefy moments. I know putting like beef in a salad is weird, but it's delicious. So, people probably do that too anyways. I don't know. It's more of a bowl. It's more of a bowl than like a salad, I guess. Pretty fucking good. Oh man, I'm like choking on the lettuce. Do I Google a lot? All the time. Did you watch, I don't know, Outer Banks yet? I don't know what that is. I've been to the Outer Banks once. Left-handed. I think this is, I'm right-handed, but maybe it looks left-handed on here because of the mirror. I don't know. I'm not left-handed. Oh man, not everyone gagging that I'm left-handed. This one is a selfie, so like, that's my right hand, this is my left hand. This is not flipped. So this is my right hand and that's my left hand. See what I said? That's so weird that everyone got so freaked out about that. I'm not like a Satanist or something, using my left hand, being a devil lady person. Thank you for liking my hair. It's like a mess and I'm not gonna do it over my food, obviously, but look at this. Oh, you can't see because Michelangelo's in the way, but I had such crazy breakage in the front here. I literally have like baby hairs. Lay my edges, queen. But then this is like so dramatic. I don't know. We're just like letting it do its thing. Living life, feeling free. That's how it's supposed to be. Marry you? I prefer not. Unless you're hot, then maybe. Can I pin my Venmo? No, because I'm about to log off in a little. But if you did want to Venmo me or whatever, I guess that's Age of Aquaria. But don't request anything because everyone be hurting and I can't be helping. In that way. People do some wild stuff. I know y'all don't understand sometimes some of the weird nuanced shit that goes on in my life and the lives of a lot of these other Drag Race girls and stuff, but people will send the wildest messages, will send the wildest Venmo requests. I'm like, sweetie, you can't just like
knock on someone's door with a bag open, like trick or treat for money. I don't know. It's just kind of weird. I'm like, I definitely am extremely charitable when I can be and helpful and stuff, but don't be doing that. Crazy. All right, so Heidi's here. Heidi's out of the closet and in my kitchen. And it's the ringtone. Oh my God, Heidi Queen. Oh my gosh, Facebook, you guys are so missing out. Heidi is on my Instagram. Queen. Very excited to watch Drag Race tonight. When is that on? At 8? I think we got like an hour and a half before that. I've got about 5 more minutes before. Thank you. It is Baja East. My friend Scott just sent me over some swag to hang around in, and I'm honestly so into it. It's like a navy and like baby blue situation. Going back over. There we go. It's got like a little burning sage moment. It says, I was reading this backwards in the mirror last night and I was like, what? It says Californication but with a K? I don't know if that means something, but it's cute and it's comfy. Favorite season 12 queen, Ross Matthews. She's the queen of all queens. And you all know it. Put some fucking respect on her name. Let's try another bite before this gets absolutely soggy. You know, I really didn't think the finishing this video part of things out. Pretty good. I'm mad. See, I saw Navy Cow stunning. Stupid. All right, well, thank you all so much for joining in. Make sure you go stan Heidi and watch Drag Race tonight if you want. And Asia's on Celebrity Secret Hush Hush drag thing, so watch Asia on that. I hope I don't have lettuce in my teeth. That'd be bad. What else? Tomorrow night at 9 o'clock? I don't know. I think it's at 9. We have the Work the World live stream. You can reserve a ticket to that at bossevents.com. The girls, honestly, and this is a behind the scenes sneak peek of some things that I know of what the other girls are doing. I'm not going to give anything away right now of what the other girls have been sharing with me that they've been planning, but from the looks and the stories of what I've been hearing that people have been working on, I think everyone will be extremely impressed. Obviously, we put a lot of hard work and thought into, you know, trying to create a performance, a number, a video that is entertaining and, you know, something with a little more production level. You know, trying to make it look as flashy as possible for you all, because obviously so many of you expect such a high level of excellence from us. And needless to say, the word on the street is a lot of the girls have worked on some really awesome things. I'm very, very excited, extremely excited to watch. And obviously, make sure to tune in and tip so that we can throw some coins to the 60 plus local entertainers and queens and clowns that we be supporting. Bye, Heidi. Good luck tonight, even though it already happened. And despite it already happening, people are still convinced that y'all all probably filmed it last week. It is so funny when people pretend like the film last year reality show is like happening right now. Like, sweetie, I know y'all don't like my shoes, but I packed those shoes last year. I can't magically, you know, like whenever someone has a critique like that, it's like, I might want to change something right now, but all that shit happened last year, so. So good.
Oh man, is this what the TikTokies do? Oh my god. I know you're not seeing the fantasy really over here on Facebook, but like dancing in the square,
or in the rectangle. Is this the fantasy? Is this what I'm missing out on? Do I need to like
do any of that nonsense? I love one of those things. I don't know. I do dancing like all this, you know? I don't do... But to each their own. If I could do it, I probably would do it. Hi, Colin! Woo!
Who's gonna save ya?
Oh, wait, I can turn it up. All right, this will be the last song, and I'm gonna eat this salad, and we're gonna have fun. Thank you for tuning in. Key change. Thank you so much. Go to sleep.